going in right now for my first visit with John and Sarah. They got a hard deadline here. We got 3 months, and we're gonna have a baby.
Hey.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi, Jackson.
How are you?
Hey, Sarah.
Hey, I'm John.
John, good to meet you guys. I gotta be honest with you, this one makes me a little nervous because Sarah's 6 months pregnant. They've got an aggressive cat named Lucy. I'm concerned as well as them, so I'm gonna go in right now and see if there's anything I can do about it. Tell me what's going on.
We have Lucy, our younger cat. She's got a lot of energy. She's really rambunctious. She likes to scratch and bite.
Wait, hold on. This is rambunctious?
Yeah.
Most of the time when I see cats biting and biting hard, it's because they could have been taught by humans that hands are toys. So they go after the hands with teeth.
Kylie is our other cat. We keep Lucy in the back of the house all day, and Kylie has the front.
They don't get along.
Lucy will creep up on Kylie, wait till she has let her guard down, and then sneak attack her.
About 6 months ago, she actually sent me to the hospital with a cat bite. She grabbed on with her back claws here. So she was like this, you know, biting, and immediately got infected within 3 days. Huge, yeah. Swollen, couldn't use my hand for anything.
That's pretty bad. When the cat sends you to the hospital, that's when my meter goes to red, and I know we gotta step in and make something happen right now.
If I had a bite of that magnitude, I don't know what I would do. I can't take antibiotics being pregnant.
I hadn't even thought of that. Sarah's doctor was saying that she couldn't take antibiotics as long as she was pregnant. And if the doctor says it, that's what we're gonna go with. That raises the stakes to me dramatically because Sarah can't get bit. I do not want her touching Lucy under any circumstances.
This is not a way to live. This is not a good environment to bring a child. I would feel like a terrible parent.
So your bottom line is?
I wouldn't hesitate to find a new home for Lucy.
It's heartbreaking to think about giving up my pet that I adore.
I could tell that we had a major problem on our hands. They were both panicked, it seemed to me. And I don't blame them. They're about to have a baby, and we've got an aggressive cat. Lucy draws blood on a daily basis. We've got a lot of things to look at. What I need to look at is the territory. So let's get cracking. Let's move.
Right.
Okay.
I had to see who owned what. What part of the house does Lucy own? What part of the house does Kylie own? But I do want to make sure I'm not putting a pregnant woman in danger.
Kylie has the habit of cornering herself over here.
There's Kylie.
Baby doll. Hi, my love. When I see a cat like Kylie scrunched behind a TV, it's the epitome of lack of confidence. Do you mind if I get you out of there? Is that okay? You're a lot of cat. She's inviting attack. If you act like prey, you're gonna be treated like prey. And that's what Kylie was doing. So we have to really up her confidence level. What do we got?
This is our soon-to-be nursery. Obviously, it's a little cluttered, a little crowded right now.
How soon are we looking at getting this done?
Basically, within 6 to 8 weeks.
Guess what?
Probably a little sooner, huh?
A lot sooner. It's not just gonna be about the architecture in here. It's the smells, the sights, the sounds. We're gonna work all that stuff in here before the baby's born, way before the baby's born.
So they get used to the furniture.
They have to get used to their environment. Basically, cats are really big creatures of habit, and I've gotta start getting them used to this space so when the new baby comes, Lucy won't feel threatened and attack John, Sarah, or the baby. Okay, so we got Lucy in here. Hi, Lucy. John, I'm gonna ask you to come in here and just show me what it is that you would normally do. I wanna see John handling her. I gotta see if there's some way that he pets her that sets her off. I'm not trying to get you sent back to the hospital, believe me. What I'm trying to do is approach that line with her, what I call the challenge line.
Hey, girl.
Oh, God.
Okay. Ow.
Sorry.
That stings.
I can't believe this. I turned my head for 1 second and boom, Sarah puts her hand the one place I didn't want it on Lucy, and Lucy attacks her. Oh, God.
Okay.
The last thing I wanted to happen for Lucy to attack Sarah, who's pregnant.
I'm gonna disinfect her really fast. Wow, that hurts.
Sarah immediately jumped out and ran out of the room. Her wounds were kind of nasty looking considering they happened so fast, but there were no bites. The vast majority of cat bites get infected. So I was just really relieved not to see a puncture mark. I don't like the fact when I look at this, I mean, it's okay for me, it's not okay for you. When Lucy finally went after Sarah the way she did, just latching onto her arm, she did it with the natural ferocity of the hunter that she is. I realize that our deadline is not when this baby's born. Our deadline is now. We're dealing with a cat that's predictable, and that is a huge plus. John and Sarah think that this is totally unprovoked? No, what she is a cat bomb. This is the cat who's locked away in the back of the house all the time. A cat with incredible drive as a hunter, and all of that energy is gonna come out where you don't want it unless you take the responsibility to drain it down. That baby is just like a prime target. I mean, no, it's true, right? Mm-hmm. Now the nursery has got to be done, and it's gotta be done by the time I get back here. You are going to be in charge of the playtime.
Okay.
You're gonna have two play sessions a day, morning and night. Playtime is essential for Lucy, who bites. We gotta get her moving on something that will drain energy off of her in a natural way. Give her what she needs, but don't present humans as targets.
Hey. Jackson, welcome back.
The stakes were so high in this home, and I'm just hoping that Lucy is less aggressive and not posing such a big threat to the baby. So guys, first day I met you, you were getting attacked on a regular basis.
Okay.
So, let's do an arm check. Please show me what's going on. Do we have any new ones?
No.
Yeah.
Give me some.
Since Jackson's been here, I don't feel like I'm tiptoeing around her as much. I don't feel like, this is gonna end in an attack. I have a way to work with her now that will just take that energy and just dispel it right away.
What else?
The supervised visit's going real well.
Kylie falls asleep, even.
With Lucy out here?
Yeah.
Wow. Last time I was here, I had to throw my body in between these two in order for mayhem to not break out.
Yeah.
So really, really positive news. So guys, the first thing I noticed when I walked in here was the shelving. So let's get up and take a look at
that. All right.
The last time I was here, I asked them to build more shelves for Kylie. So that rocks right there. So Kylie will go 1, 2, 3.
I've seen her do that, yes.
Great. The thing with Kylie was to get that confidence up. We took this cat, we got her off the ground, and once we did, she didn't present herself on the level of target that Lucy needed in order to be activated. So now, Lucy's activated by the things that we want her to be activated by. So our next stop was the nursery. And the first day that I was here, that space was like a second garage. There wasn't anything in there that even resembled a nursery. First of all, this is a complete nursery. You've got it.
I believe so.
These shelves are a great step in the right direction, and I just love the fact that everything's in place here. Settling into this baby's arrival also means the cats can settle into this baby's arrival. These guys knocked my socks off. They really did. Fantastic work. Exciting.
Yeah.
Exciting in here, right? Let's keep moving. I know there's other stuff we want to see before I leave today, so come on. I sent John into the next room where Kylie was, and I had Lucy come on over to hang out. At that point, I had John bring Kylie into the room and sit down. Now watch, she's looking over there. See how I got her attention? She's doing the blink, she's calmed down. Now we could see what was gonna happen. There's Kylie. Go, girl, yeah. See, now this is the kind of thing I could not get the last time I was here. Right now, I know that I can keep getting her attention away from Kylie. It's so cool. Lucy's no longer that cat bomb ready to go off because they're learning how to get rid of that energy in the correct way, which means she's no longer going after them or Kylie. That is a cat that has changed dramatically. One last question. We got a baby coming soon. How are you feeling now about having baby and cat together?
I really feel confident that we've got this now. I see results, and I'm eager to see what it looks like 6 more weeks from now.
Yeah, totally.
There was a point where I was definitely ready to kind of give up and rehome Lucy, but now I have the knowledge that I need in order to make the situation work. So that's a pretty big deal.
I couldn't be more thankful because Jackson kept our family together.
Have a nice, easy birth.
Thank you.
I'm completely confident walking away from here today knowing that there's a baby coming into this world safe from attacks from a cat. I couldn't be happier when a child grows up with animals because they're the next generation of animal lovers. And with this family, I know that's the case.